I am by the M1 in North London. Motorway goes up to, I don't know where, Birmingham or Manchester or somewhere up north. Just starts down the road. You can just about see, going across it, the flyover of the North Circular Road. Basically, it's a hot summer's day, bank holiday, Monday, August 2019, and I thought I'd go out for a walk. It's boiling hot, it's 10 o'clock in the morning, and it's already 26 degrees Celsius, that is, what, 77 Fahrenheit? It's forecast to go up to about 31, which is something like it, 86, 87. So yeah, I've got a bottle of water, there you go. I've got my sun hat on. I'm hoping I can handle it. It's super humid, basically, that's the problem. It's not that the temperature is so hot. But anyway, I thought I'd go for a walk. I'm gonna go down Cool Oak Lane and look at the nature reserve again. Been there before, but it's a different time, a different day. Let's see how it goes. This place is West Hendon. H-E-N-D-O-N. Don't think they keep chickens here though. Actually, I think there is a chicken farm somewhere up the road, but anyway, it's not known for it. Lots of litter, because the council doesn't bother with the scruffy areas for some reason. There are posh parts of Hendon which are spotless. And then there's West Hendon. New flats there. Rectangular, unoriginal looking, but I guess they're probably all right. Cardboard walls. Lots of marigolds. These houses, on the other hand, are 1930s style houses. Much better. And beyond the price of most people now. If you inherit one, great. But not many people can afford to buy them anymore. And we have more flats up ahead. Kind of look like warehouses, don't they? Container stores or something. For slotting people in. They're what the estate agents call bijou flats, that is Agenda 21 style. Small flats with not much storage space. A sneaky way of getting people to consume less without being caught out for it. Because if you haven't got anywhere to keep your stuff, you either trade up, which people can't afford to do, or you don't buy so much stuff. Probably good for the environment, but it's kind of a sneaky way of doing it, isn't it? And of course they're smaller because, in part, the market forces it, because prices are too high for bigger ones. Here's nature, look, rose hips. If you want a bit of vitamin C, these are the fellows. Not really ripe yet. Or maybe past it, I don't know. Better wait to see the traffic light, hadn't I? Although there's not much traffic. I already pushed the button. It didn't activate, okay. Right. They're hoping to get fed, I think. We are Welsh Harp Reservoir. And 10 o'clock in the morning is a bit too early for most people. So it's not too busy yet, I suppose. The North Circular Road runs along that side, behind the trees there. Meanwhile, the residents argue. A bit like an episode of EastEnders here. We'll never know how it turned out. Yeah. There are a few little blackberries here, but hardly. I suppose it's the end of the season, really, surely. More rose hip. I suppose that's hawthorn. I don't really know. Not edible, I expect. Again, I don't know. I wouldn't want to chance it personally without looking it up first. See if I can find a ripe one. Oops. Quite nice. Oh, I don't know if you can see the dragonfly there. Could hardly see it myself. Well camouflaged. Cabbage white butterfly. Let's have a peek, shall we? Just bashing the microphone there. is it elderberry or is it not? My feeling is it's not. But I don't know. I look at pictures of these things and they're never the same as what you see when you're out here. Because every plant is an individual. And nature's full of lookalikes. So the real thing is super nutritious. The lookalike is just toxic. Well, these black currants are pretty good. Not like ones I had in Hampstead, which were like paint. Not black currants, blackberries. Nobody out here but us joggers. And people wheeling their luggage along for some reason. The Egyptian goose there standing on the branch. I think there's a coconut floating in the water. Actually, there's a couple, and I remember a couple of coconuts here from like a couple of years ago. It could even be the same ones. Oh, and there's a third coconut. I startled him. Didn't like my hat, probably. Lots of tiny black currants there. Why are they so small? Maybe it's a particular variety of plant. But tiny. horse chestnut trees are starting to turn brown on the leaves. Usually happens around the end of August. I've seen it much earlier and occasionally later, but I guess the plants are expecting summer to end on schedule this year, which means by the second week of September, 3 weeks hence, maybe two, well three I suppose, the weather's going to be rotten, dull and miserable and raining probably, and a lot cooler. Gathering blackberries, I think. I should do it myself, really. And yet more, but again, tiny. Yes, in a conventional year, when September comes, at some point in the first 2 weeks, it's like somebody flicks a switch. The sun gets dimmer, noticeably, and the weather gets far cloudier and substantially cooler. In recent years, this has then been followed by warm Octobers. It used to be the case that a warm October would happen. They call it an Indian summer. It would happen maybe once in 10 years, but we've had it maybe 3 years out of four for the last decade. Well, these look ripe. Slightly different flavour, sweeter. And they've got a bit of that paint taste from Hampstead, only slightly. So maybe they are a different variety. I've seen a lot of people lately with electric bicycles. Seems to be this year's thing. If I ever move out of London, I'll be tempted to get one, actually. Maybe a scooter, I don't know. But I can't move out of London at the moment because I need a job. And frankly, this is the only place in most of Europe where there are any jobs. I retire in 6 years. So, yeah. So when I turn 67, I think, because I'm 60 now, believe it or not. One advantage of being 60 in London is free travel on the entire transport system. All of Greater London, which is an area the size of a county. 60 miles across, basically. The only real restriction is I can't use certain branches before 9:30 in the morning on the overground trains. But I have alternatives, so it doesn't matter. So that'll save me £150 a month on travel costs. Running away. These plants are yellow flag iris, but there's no flowers on them at the moment. Can you hear the main road over there? I can. Acorns. More of these tiny blackberries, sorry. Yeah, again, the flavour's not quite so good on those. Better stick to the bigger ones. Unless I'm desperate for some vitamins. Then we do what the Stone Age people did, and eat whatever. And also learn which ones are actually edible. can see Wembley Stadium over there. Somebody's starting to sail. They usually sail on the lake on any day, but there's not much wind today. It's hot and sunny and humid and hardly any breeze. Some more rose hip, darker red this time. There's the leaves. Here's the the fruit or whatever they are. Not much flavour. Can't even taste any vitamin C in that one. There may be some, I don't know. Well, that's basically it for today. There are lots and lots of walks, as you can see, around London, all the way around London, actually, if you really want to go to places. I can walk to Woolwich Foot Tunnel, 24 and a half miles, yeah. Definitely. Okay, well that's it for today. I will see you in another video. Bye for now.